But the ones which are giving a black colored is the main.
No, that is the there is a I don't know whether you have heard the Bragg's law. So those are satisfying Bragg's law. Basically, they are diffracting more.
Yeah.
So those are coming black.
Okay.
Because
of their arrangements, you know.
Arrangements, yeah. They, with respect to the electron beam, how they are aligned.
So accordingly, they are giving. If they are reflecting, then this is what they are giving.
Yeah.
Otherwise, if they are not reflecting, they are giving.
Yeah,
they are
more or less means lighter color.
Okay.
Are
you taking
the
yes, yes, yes.
So, for this is these are very small crystals.
This is the highest,
see.
Sir.
Huh?
This is the highest.
10 nanometers.
No, no, I can go to 1 million up
to,
huh?
What?
1 million times, huh?
Can you see that?
Sir,
what's
that, sir?
Can
you
see that, sir?
In that magnification, I need very much stability. So, you can see here that I am now at 260 kx. Huh?
Okay.
So, I am going higher. You can see that I am now 898, and then when I take it out this screen, you can see that.
Kx stands for?
K means kilo.
Kilo.
And then
minus.
It is 1 mx, means
okay.
Million times.
Oh my God.
One.
So show this one.
So I will not show at that magnification because it damaged the specimen too much. So
okay.
I will show you other things. So these are the crystals. So basically this, when the parallel ray comes and the objective lens, it falls in the back focal plane, it converts like this. Okay. And then you see the transmitted beam, and those are with this atomic arrangement, they are diffracted. Yeah?
Okay.
So those coherently diffracted, that also focus at some other point. Those are the diffraction spots. So if some a bigger crystal we take and then then you see this kind of spots. This is the diffraction spots. So this is the transmitted beam and these are the diffracted beams. So from here one can calculate the de-spacing, atomic interplanar spacing.
Okay.
And
atomic spacing.
No,
that's not the nucleus. It's the diffraction.
Diffraction.
The problem is
that
it is main light is diffracting. Diffraction is taking place
from
there. Diffraction is something like you know this optical microscope which is going to be, huh?
Yes.
So, let me tell you. So you see these electrons, parallel electron comes and then this is a specimen, then this is the objective lens, then in the back focal plane, you see those are coming this way parallel, this focus at that, this is a transmitted one. And then those are diffracted like this dotted one.
Mm.
So they will focus at another point. So those are the diffract.
This is the thing that we are seeing
in this one. So in both information, this plane or this plane, we can take at the same time. So that is the advantage.
Okay.
Reciprocal space we called and the real space. We can map it same time. So this is possible because we use in this microscope electromagnetic lenses.
Okay.
So electromagnetic lenses, we can change its power by changing its current. So we can, this back focal plane we project to this screen. Also, the image plane we can project to the screen by changing that power. Okay, so that I can explain. There is an image I can explain. But there I'll tell you later.
We are not taking one.
If something, suppose you 1 centimeter object, you can